The General Mills Radio Adventure Theater. Welcome to the magic world of radio. I'm Tom Bosley, and today I'd like to introduce you to an old friend whom I first met when I was just about your age. His name is Aladdin. One day, he found a wonderful lamp in which there lived a genie. Now, in those days, long ago, people believed that the world was full of mighty spirits who could do the most fantastic things. They could change their shapes at will, and though they were as tall as mountains, they could still fit comfortably into an oil lamp. And they were called genies. Our adventure story, Aladdin and His Wonderful Lamp, was adapted from the Arabian Nights, especially for the General Mills Radio Adventure Theater by Paul Tripp, and stars Roger Barron. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Our adventure takes place in China, the oldest civilized country in the world. It was born over 4,000 years ago and has given us some of the most wonderful things ever devised by man. Printing and paper were first invented by the Chinese, and they were the first people to use gunpowder, silk, and porcelain. They also have a very interesting custom. When Chinese babies are born, they're immediately considered to be 1 year old. In a land where so many marvelous and interesting things have happened, it's not surprising that Aladdin should have had such a fantastic adventure with his wonderful lamp.
Is there any more rice, Mother? I'm still hungry.
Here, Aladdin, finish my bowl.
Oh, no, Mother. You eat little enough as it is.
Oh, my son. How shall we live? This is the last of the rice. Our shop is open. There is merchandise on the shelves. But no one comes in to buy it. When your father was alive, the shop was always full of customers.
I'm sorry, Mother. I guess I wasn't cut out to be a merchant.
Oh, I'm not blaming you. You're young and inexperienced.
But I'm also strong. There's just one thing to do. Go out into the city and find work. Then at least we shall not starve.
My boy, where are you off to?
Good day, Mr. Chen. I'm off to the marketplace to earn some money. Do you know of someone who would hire me? I'll do anything.
Well, let me think. Wait a moment. Of course. I was speaking to Manchu the magician yesterday. His assistant has run away. Not that I blame him. Manchu is not an easy man to work for.
I'll work for anyone, as long as he pays.
Then let me take you to meet him. Greetings, most honorable magician. Permit me to introduce my neighbor's son, Aladdin. I have brought him to replace your assistant.
Turn around, boy. Let me look at you.
I have no experience, sir.
Doesn't matter. I do all the work. You just hand me the tricks.
Ah,
yes, I think the young man will do. What is your name? Aladdin? You're hired.
There you are, Aladdin. Now be sure you do everything you're told to do.
And now, honorable magician, I am at your service. What do I do first?
First, you shall accompany me on a long walk to those mountains out there.
Mountains? Is that where you perform your magic?
Perhaps. Now hold your tongue and follow me.
We have searched on top of this mountain forever. What are we looking for?
A square, flat stone with a brass ring in the middle. Now look sharp. The clouds are thick up here. That's it. My boy, your feet see better than your eyes. You tripped over it. Now, give me a hand with this brass ring that we may raise the stone. All right, heave now. Heave harder.
Oh, but there's only a hole here. Is this what you were looking for?
Yes. You see, At the bottom of this hole lies a great treasure. You will climb down through this opening and bring it up to me. Here. Now, I will tie this rope around you and lower you to the bottom. Quickly now.
All right, but be careful you don't let me fall. I've reached bottom. Slack the rope and I'll look around.
What have you found?
Nothing. There's no treasure down here.
A lamp. Have you found a lamp?
Well, yes. A grimy old oil lamp. But I don't call that a treasure.
Never mind that. Just tie the rope to the lamp and I'll pull it up.
But what about me?
I'll pull you up next.
But why not both of us at the same time?
Do as I say, boy. The lamp. First the lamp.
No. You're trying to trick me. You said there was a treasure down here. You were lying. Pull me up as well, or you'll not have the lamp.
And by the celestial gods, you shall stay down there forever. Farewell, Aladdin.
Help! Help! I'll never live to get out of this place. I don't understand. Why was Manchu so anxious to have this lamp? It's covered with thick grime. Could it be gold underneath? Let me rub some of this away.
You called, Master? What is thy will? Command me, and it shall be done.
Where did you come from?
From the lamp, of course. Do not be afraid. Have you never met a magic genie before?
No. But, I'll get used to it. Did you say I could command you?
I am thy slave. What is thy wish?
Get me out of this place and take me home.
I hear and I obey.
There you are, Aladdin. Where have you been? I've been so worried. Did you earn any money?
No, Mother. Just this lamp. I'm sorry. I wish it were more.
Oh, well, never mind. You tried. I'll clean and polish the lamp. Perhaps we can sell it for some food.
No, Mother. Wait.
Did you forget something, Master? I was just falling off to sleep.
It was an accident.
Now, what is your wish?
Well, as long as you're here, could you bring us something to eat? My mother and I are very hungry.
Oh, what is all that food doing on the table?
The magic genie brought it. He lives in this lamp. When you rubbed it, he came forth. Oh,
never have I seen such delicious food. Fit for earth. They're all solid gold. We will sell those and have enough to live on.
Hear ye, hear ye. The Emperor hereby commands that all citizens turn their backs, that they may not see his daughter, the princess, pass by. Anybody caught looking at the princess will be punished without mercy.
Aladdin, come away from that window. If you're caught, you will be killed.
Don't worry, Mother. Nobody can see me. But I want to see the princess. I've heard she's very beautiful. Oh.
What is it, Aladdin? Have they seen you?
No, Mother. But I have seen the princess. Oh, she is the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. And I'm going to marry her.
Oh, my poor boy. You must have a fever.
I'm serious, Mother. I shall ask the genie to help me. He can do anything. He told me so.
Very well.
Come forth, genie.
Is a genie never to sleep? What is thy command, Master?
I love the Emperor's daughter, and I wish to marry her. Will you help me?
But what can I do? In all my 1,000 years, I have never been asked about love. But it is rather an interesting problem.
You see, Aladdin, not even a genie can help you.
Be silent, woman. I'm thinking. Ah, I have it. Here, I place in your hands a basket full of emeralds and diamonds and rubies and pearls. Take them now to the emperor and tell him your son Aladdin wishes to marry his daughter.
Let all those who wish to address his imperial majesty approach.
Oh, mighty emperor, I ask a favor.
What is the favor, my good woman?
That you do not have me punished when I say what I have to say.
Such a little favor. Very well. It is granted. What have you to say to me?
My son, Aladdin, wishes to marry your daughter.
What? Be silent, Prime Minister. Continue. O mother of a son who wishes to marry my daughter.
And as a token of his love for your daughter, my son Aladdin wishes you to have these jewels.
Where's the beard of Confucius? These jewels are brighter than the sun. Your son values my daughter very much.
He loves her very much, O mighty one.
How can I refuse such a loving heart? Tell your son, my good woman, to come to the palace 3 months from today, and he shall marry my daughter.
I go. May you be blessed forever.
Well, forgive me, O majestic one. But did you not promise that my son would marry the princess?
And so he shall. 3 months from today.
Well, then, why?
Behold these glorious jewels that the woman gave me, and in return have I not given her 3 months of happiness until the day she returns to find out that I have changed my mind?
Oh, wisest of all kings on earth, I am speechless with admiration.
Oh, mother, this is the happiest day of my life. The 3 months of waiting have gone by like 3 minutes. How do I look?
Oh, like a happy bridegroom, my son. Oh, I do so hope the princess will not notice the new patches on your clothes.
Have you heard the news? The princess is being married today.
I know, Mr. Chen. I'm the bridegroom.
You? Oh, you are a great joker, Aladdin. The princess is marrying the prime minister's son. And I've been invited to watch. I must hurry now, or I shall be late.
Oh, no.
But the emperor promised you, my son. I heard him with my own ears.
I won't have it. Even an emperor must keep his word. I'll make him keep his word.
Aladdin, what are you doing?
Calling forth the genie. He'll know what to do.
Well, Aladdin, how did the wedding go?
It didn't. The emperor broke his promise. In a few minutes, he's marrying the princess to the prime minister's son.
What? Does the emperor think he is mightier than a genie? We must stop the wedding.
Now, you'd think a man as wise and mighty as an emperor would never stoop to play such a dirty trick. Well, perhaps he needs to be taught a lesson. It's never too late to learn. Now, we don't know what the genie's planning, but one thing is certain. We'll meet you at the wedding in a few moments with Act Two, no matter who the bridegroom is. The General Mills Radio Adventure Theater will return shortly. Come to think of it, maybe we've all been barking up the wrong tree. Aladdin was so sure he'd marry the princess, he convinced us as well. But let's face it, although the old saying goes, a cat can look at a king, nobody ever said anything about a pauper marrying a princess. But then, nobody ever said anything about a genie planning a wedding either.
It's all settled. There will be no wedding.
Listen, the music has stopped.
Of course. Can't have a wedding without a bridegroom, can we?
What's happened to the Prime Minister's son?
He seems to have vanished in a puff of smoke. Go now at once, O mother of Aladdin, to the palace, and tell the emperor he must marry the princess to your son, as he promised.
Come near, mother of Aladdin, and speak.
Oh, mighty one, 3 months ago, you promised my son would marry the princess on this very day.
I did.
What kind of an emperor breaks a promise?
You are right. I did promise. An emperor must always keep his word. However, there is one simple request I must now make. Before the wedding, your son must first send me 40 chests filled to the brim with jewels and carried by 40 slaves. Let him do so, and he shall be married.
But that is impossible.
Well, that is your problem, my good woman. Meanwhile, we shall resume the festivities and await the coming of your son and his 40 chests of jewels.
Listen, Jeannie. The music has started again.
Oh, that treacherous emperor. Aladdin, he wishes you to deliver 40 slaves carrying 40 chests of jewels.
Oh.
A simple request, he calls it.
And so it is. Both of you go back to the palace. The slaves and their jewels will be there for you. Wait. You can't go dressed like that.
Mother, look at me.
Oh, my son. Now you look like a prince. But what about me, Jeannie? Am I to go in rags?
No, very well.
What a beautiful robe.
Now go. And Aladdin, take the lamp with you. Hide it under your robe. You may still need me.
Tell the emperor that Aladdin, his son-in-law-to-be, has arrived with 40 slaves, bearing 40 chests of treasure.
Fantastic. I don't believe such jewels.
Prime Minister, have you ever seen such wealth before? Summon the princess. Come to my arms, Aladdin, my son. Let the marriage ceremony begin. My dear children, you must both stay here and live with me in the palace.
Forgive me, most royal father-in-law, but we shall live in a palace of our own. If you will excuse me for a moment, I shall withdraw behind that curtain and think of what kind of a palace it shall be. Come forth, Jeannie. Shh! Jeannie, must you always be so noisy every time you come out of the bottle?
I'm sorry, Master. How did it go?
Very well. Thank you very much. Now I have one more request.
I hear and I obey.
I want you to build us a palace. It must be of the finest marble, with floors made of purest gold, and...
Say no more. I know exactly what you have in mind. Is this what you mean?
Father! Father! Come to the window and see the palace Aladdin has built for me.
Do you like it, Mei Ling?
Like it? I adore it.
Magnificent, truly. Magnificent. It puts my own palace to shame. Oh, Aladdin, what a marvelous young man you are.
Ah, greetings, most honorable Manchu the magician. We have missed you. Where have you been for so long a time?
Persia, India, Africa, learning new feats of magic. Excuse me, Mr. Chen, but it is time to start my performance. Who was that handsome general who just rode by at the head of his troops?
Have you forgotten so soon, Manchu? That was Aladdin, the young man you once hired as your assistant.
Aladdin? But I thought he was dead.
Dead? Whatever gave you such a ridiculous idea? After he met you, he married the emperor's daughter, built the most fantastic palace you have ever seen, and will rule over China when the present emperor is dead. Can you believe it? I don't know how he's done it.
I know.
You do?
Where did you say Aladdin's palace was?
Well, I didn't, but it's next to the Empress.
Ah, yes, thank you. And now, if you will excuse me, I must leave. There will be no performance today. So, Aladdin did not die after all, and the wretch stole the lamp. How else could he have become so prosperous? But I shall have my revenge. I shall take the lamp from him and undo all his good fortune. I shall ruin him. But first, the lamp. I must have that lamp.
New lamps for old. New lamps for old.
You there, peddler? Yes, you. Come into the palace. I would speak to you.
You called, most gracious lady? Oh, this is indeed a fabulous palace.
Yes, isn't it? My husband, Aladdin, built it for me.
And may I humbly inquire if your husband is at home with you?
Oh, no. He has gone off to war. But I did not ask you in to discuss my husband or my palace. Tell me, peddler, are you really giving away new lamps for old?
Oh, truly so, gracious lady.
Oh, but you cannot be serious.
Have you any old lamps, your royal highness? If so, I will take them and give you this bright, shining lamp in exchange.
Well, we do have one old lamp around here somewhere. Aladdin seems very fond of it, though I cannot guess why.
May I see it?
Well, it's on that table over there. You see? Is it not an ugly, grimy lamp?
Oh, yes, it is. Hardly fitting in such a splendid palace.
That is what I am always telling Aladdin. But he just laughs.
May I hold it?
Of course you may. Here.
At last!
But why are you polishing the lamp? It is not gold, I assure you.
What is thy wish, master? But you are not Aladdin.
No, I am not Aladdin. I am Manchu the magician and your new master.
I do not understand. What is happening?
What have you done to Aladdin? He was a good master.
Genie, you are now my slave. You are sworn to obey the owner of this lamp, and the lamp is now mine.
Do not listen to him, Genie.
Alas, I must. He speaks the truth. He is the master, and I am his slave, and I must obey him. What is thy wish, master?
That you carry this palace, the princess and myself, to the most faraway place where no one will think to look for us.
And where would that be, master?
Insolent slave, you know as well as I do, to the Gobi Desert in Mongolia.
Oh, please. Take the palace if you must, but leave me here.
She comes with us, Genie. Do as I command.
Very well, master. I hear and I obey. I'm sorry, princess.
Your Majesty, a great and terrible misfortune has befallen us.
What misfortune, Prime Minister? Has Aladdin's army lost the battle?
No. He has not yet returned. But look through that window. The palace is gone.
Gone? And the princess, my daughter?
Gone as well.
Oh, woe is me. What evil power has done this?
Aladdin, your majesty. He has brought this evil upon us. Aladdin is an evil magician who fooled us all to win the hand of your daughter.
But what's to be done?
When Aladdin returns from battle, he must be forced to return your daughter, and then he must die.
Great news, your majesty. We have beaten the enemy.
But why do you look so stern, my dear father-in-law? Is this not a time for rejoicing?
Where is my daughter, Aladdin?
Why, in the palace, I suppose.
And where is the palace?
Why, it's out there. You can see it from this window. Well, it's gone.
Yes, evil magician. It is gone. You have stolen the palace and the princess.
Oh, but this is nonsense. I am no magician.
And how have you, who once were so poor, won your way into our hearts?
Oh, that? Well, it's very simple. I found a lamp in which a genie lived. It was he who helped me with this magic.
Show me the lamp, and I will believe you.
Alas, I cannot. It was in the palace with the princess, my wife. Now, if they are gone, the lamp is gone as well.
And you cannot return my daughter to me?
Without the lamp, I can do nothing.
Then you must be made to suffer. Send for the executioner and his sword. On your knees, Aladdin, and bow your head. For the end of your life has come.
And just when things were going so well for Aladdin, to make things worse, the lamp is gone. And without the lamp and the genie, Aladdin is right back where he started. Just a poor young man wondering what's going to happen next. We'll rejoin you shortly with Act Three. The General Mills Radio Adventure Theater will return shortly. Do you believe in miracles? Sometimes it's pretty hard to, isn't it? It took us and Aladdin quite a time to get used to the magic genie. And he was a miracle if ever I saw one. Aladdin certainly needs a miracle now. But from where will it come? The genie is fast asleep in his lamp far away in the Gobi Desert. Aladdin's on his own now.
Is the executioner ready?
He is ready.
Your Majesty, before I die, let me speak but once more.
Speak, but be brief.
The Prime Minister has called me an evil magician. In your heart, you must know he lies. In his bitterness, because the princess married me instead of his son, he now wants to destroy me.
Do not listen to him, Majesty. Let the executioner strike now. I pray you. Before it is too late.
No! No.
Is this disturbance outside my palace?
Your Majesty, your army is in revolt. They say that if Aladdin dies, they will tear the palace down.
So, Aladdin, not only have you stolen my daughter, but you have also turned my army against me.
It is more of his evil magic.
No, it is not evil magic. It is their love for me, the general who has led them from one victory to another.
Lies! Lies! Let the executioner strike! They're breaking into the palace! Flee for your life, my emperor!
Peace! Peace! Let there be peace in this palace. Soldiers of my army, your emperor speaks. Let there be peace. I will spare Aladdin's life if he restores my daughter to me within 30 days. Your emperor has spoken. You have heard my words, Aladdin.
I have heard, and I am grateful, O merciful one.
Then go forth and seek my daughter.
Do not trust him, Majesty. He will go and never return.
Then shall his mother meet the executioner in his stead. So, go, Aladdin, and make haste. I shall not be merciful again.
Mother! Mother, we must speak quickly, for I have no time.
Oh, Aladdin, the Emperor has spared your life. I had already begun to mourn you. But why should he wish to kill you?
Because while I was away, fighting the enemy, someone came and stole the princess and the palace.
Then call forth the genie. He will help you.
Oh, no, Mother. The lamp is gone as well.
Oh, then all is lost. Oh, go, my son. Flee to another country and do not return.
Oh, if I do not return within 30 days, the emperor will have you executed instead.
How could anybody steal such a bright and shining palace? And in broad daylight?
Oh, it was stolen last night when the city was asleep.
Last night? Wait. Wait, I have a thought. Last night, I could not sleep. I went to the window to get a breath of air. Suddenly, I saw a star shoot across the sky. The greatest, most radiant shooting star I have ever seen.
It turned night into day.
Mother, that was no shooting star. That was the palace being carried off by the genie to some faraway place.
What?
Quick, which way did it go?
It went in that direction, I think.
Let me see. That would be a westward direction toward the north. Now, what place lies northwest of here? I must think. Why, of course, the Gobi Desert, where there is nothing but emptiness and sand. No one would think to look for a palace there.
I pray you, magician, take me back to my husband and my father.
Oh, stop your weeping, princess. Tomorrow you and I shall be married and live happily ever after.
Never. I am married to Aladdin.
But have you not heard? There is no Aladdin.
Oh, no.
Your husband is dead, princess.
I don't believe it. I won't listen to you.
Believe or don't believe, tomorrow you shall be my wife.
No. No.
Suddenly, I feel very sleepy. I think the wine was too strong. Yes, I shall sleep now. Yes, I shall sleep.
Who is that in this empty desert?
Mei-Ling! Mei-Ling, open the window and let me in.
Aladdin!
Where is he? Where is the man who stole you away from me?
There.
Manchu, the magician, I might have guessed.
You know him?
A long time ago, he left me in a deep hole to die. Quickly now, before he wakes. Where is the lamp?
In his robe. He never lets it out of his sight.
Not a sound now. I must have that lamp, or we are lost.
What? Who is it? Who is it? Aladdin. My lamp. Where is my lamp?
In the hands of its rightful owner, villain.
Give me back that lamp.
Aladdin, how did you get here? Oh, how glad I am to see you. Command me, O worthy master, and I shall obey gladly.
Quickly, then. Carry this palace back to where it once stood, and take me and my princess also.
And what shall I do with this worthless magician? Squash him beneath my fingers?
No, we shall leave him here in the desert to wander for the rest of his days.
Great news, O noble emperor. The missing palace has been returned.
And my daughter, where is she?
Father, I am safe, thanks to Aladdin.
Oh, my dearest daughter, I have given you up for lost.
Hail, O mighty emperor, my loving father-in-law. Your daughter is safe in your arms. Have I not kept my word?
Oh, my most noble Aladdin, how can you ever forgive me for doubting you?
There is nothing to be forgiven, O majestic one.
You shall serve me as my prime minister. You are a true and faithful man.
Greetings, most holy woman.
You are most kind to receive me in your palace, O beautiful princess. Is your husband Aladdin at home at this moment?
No, he has gone hunting. But he should be here any moment.
I shall be honored to meet him when he returns. Oh, what a beautiful palace he has built for you. Yet, one thing is still lacking.
Lacking? But this palace is perfect.
It would be, but for one thing.
And what is that?
The lights that hang on the ceiling above us are too dim for such a splendid palace. Uh-huh. If the sun hung there, this palace would then indeed be perfect.
What a marvelous idea. But how could that be done?
I have heard that your husband has a wonderful lamp that can do anything. Bring it forth and command it to hang the sun from the ceiling before your husband returns.
But I do not know where the lamp is. Aladdin keeps it hidden.
Oh, I'm sorry. It would have been such a wonderful surprise.
Welcome back, Aladdin. Oh,
I have had the most wonderful idea while you were gone.
Aren't you going to ask me how my hunting went first?
Oh, later, later. First, bring forth the lamp.
But why?
I wish you to ask the genie to do something wonderful for us.
Well, I don't understand, but I can refuse you nothing, Mei Ling. Very well, then. Here is the lamp.
Oh, that is where you keep it hidden. Now, quickly, rub the lamp.
Very well.
What is thy wish, master?
Let the princess tell you. Tell him, Mei Ling.
Genie, I command you to take the sun from the heavens and have it hang from this ceiling instead of those dismal lights.
What? Oh, wretched children. Have I not done enough for you? Such a command is unnatural and dangerous. If the sun hung from this ceiling, the palace would be in ashes in an instant. What evil person has suggested such a request?
It was Fatima, the holy woman.
She is no more Fatima, the holy woman, than I am. What? You foolish girl. Did you not recognize Manchu, the magician, in disguise?
Where is he, Mei Ling? Where is he?
In the other room.
Too late. He has already escaped.
Oh, no, he hasn't. Oh, guards! Catch that man running from the palace. The man dressed in woman's clothing.
Let me go! I'm a poor innocent woman. Let me go!
He is taken, most noble lord. Throw him into the deepest dungeon you can find. Put 20 strong locks on the door and then throw away the keys. We are rid of him forever.
But what if he should escape and steal the lamp again?
He may escape, but he shall never have the lamp again. Worthy genie, I have been thinking. I have all the good fortune and wealth any man could desire, thanks to you. Therefore, I command you to take this lamp and hide it in a place that no man can ever find.
But if no man ever finds this lamp again, then who will ever command me again?
No one. I give you your freedom. Henceforth, you shall sleep in your lamp to your heart's content for as long as you wish. This is my last command to you. Now, do as I say.
I hear and I obey.
And thank you very much, genie.
You are most
he lived many, many years ago, Aladdin had a very modern mind. Today, so many people claim to have seen UFOs, unidentified flying objects, which supposedly come from other planets in outer space. Aladdin is the only man I know who ever identified such a flying object correctly when he realized the shooting star his mother had seen was actually the stolen palace. I'll be back shortly. You may not have realized it, but there are genies in the world today. But we call them by different names. Electricity is the genie who lives in a light bulb and lights up the world at night. Steam, that's the genie which has run factories and driven locomotives for many years. Nuclear energy is a genie whose power is far greater than Aladdin's. And there's another genie who's carrying my voice to you at this very moment. The genie we call radio. Our cast included Roger Barron, E.V. Juster, Robert Dryden, Norman Rose, and Roger DeCoven. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. This is Tom Bosley inviting you to return to the General Mills Radio Adventure Theater for another exciting tale you can hear through the magic of radio. The General Mills Radio Adventure Theater is recommended by NEA, the National Education Association.